The president is bragging about making up facts in a conversation with one of America's closest allies. CNN confirms that the president boasted about lying to Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau about trade deficits. But now, in a really unbelievable twist, and I mean that in every way, the president is pushing back on the story with, frankly, a new lie. This is what the president says. We do have a trade deficit with Canada, even though we don't. We do not. To be clear, there is no trade deficit with Canada. There is a trade surplus. Who says that? The U.S. government says that. The Trade Office and the Commerce Department both say that. The government that the President of the United States works in says that. I'm now joined by Josh Dossey of The Washington Post, who broke the news that the president was bragging about making things up in conversations with the Canadian Prime Minister. Josh, first tell me where he did this and what he said.
So thanks for having me. He did this last night at a fundraiser in Missouri for Josh Hawley. The president was on a two-day trip where he went to California and obviously saw the border wall prototypes, did a fundraiser, and then last night in Missouri to about 60 donors, he gave 30 minutes of contemporaneous off-the-cuff remarks where he ticked through foreign and domestic issues, and he did this as part of that speech to that fundraiser.
And he says, you know, relate the story. He was with Canadian Prime Minister Justin right. Trudeau, and during negotiations, he right. said the United States has a trade deficit with Canada. Right. Then what happened?
So the president was riffing to these donors, and he was saying when Justin Trudeau came and met with him at the White House, the prime minister said, President Trump, we don't have a trade deficit with you like you think. We don't have the deficit's not there. And President Trump said, I just assumed, yeah, we do. He goes, I didn't have any facts. I didn't know anything. I kind of made it up because we have a trade deficit with everyone in the president's eyes. He said, and I assumed we were stupid and they were smart and they had a better deal than we did. The president said he got his experts and his team to look up some data for him and came back and said there wasn't a deficit unless you counted it a certain way. And that's how he's trying to explain his comments to Trudeau and now on Twitter this morning.
In this fundraiser last night, he admits that when his own experts came back to him, they told him, no, Mr. President, there's no trade deficit with Canada. Yet this morning, he's putting out this, frankly, just flat-out false information that there is a trade deficit with Canada. Let us leave that aside for a moment. He also said something very interesting about South Korea as well, Josh.
Right. Well, these were stemwinder comments. The president really ticked through a number of the United States allies and said, essentially, our allies are not looking out for us. They're looking out for themselves. And when he was talking about South Korea, he said South Korea and the United States had a trade deal that was outdated, that South Korea had become rich and the United States had not gotten any of those riches, and is trying to negotiate a new trade deal with South Korea. The president said, we have 32,000 troops along the border between South Korea and North Korea, and let's see what happens. We're protecting them and we're losing money from them. Obviously, others disagree with his characterization of that, but let's see what happens if they don't give us a better deal. The president ticked through Japan, China, the NATO, I mean, the WTO, the European Union, all of these different groups who he really thinks are jilting the United States. And he promised to impose new tariffs. You know, his tariffs have been very controversial, even in Republican circles, but he wants to impose new tariffs, mm-hmm. particularly on foreign cars. And the thesis of his speech was essentially he thinks the United States is, mm-hmm. is being screwed.
Josh Dossey for us. Thank you very much. And again, this is all on tape, so there's no denying that the president said all of these things, bragging about lying, among others.